The Lord is given, the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. The walls and rule of the Lord rise against me, and this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. From the time of trouble, he shall hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. Now will my head be lifted up above my enemies, or round about me. And therefore will I offer that in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will say, yea, I will say, praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, and have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou saddest, seek ye my face. Thy face, O Lord, shall I see. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me. O God of my salvation, when my father and mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of thy righteousness. Deliver me not only to the will of my enemy, for false witness has risen up against me, and such have moved out cruelty. I have faith, except I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And so wait on the Lord. Live with courage. He shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The Lord is our help in the time of trouble. For the earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he has established it upon the feet. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? And who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart. He that hath not sworn deceitfulness, nor lifted up his soul to vanity. He shall receive the blessing of the Lord and the righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation that seek, thy face, O Lord. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up the everlasting door. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong in might. The Lord, mighty in battle. He is the King of glory. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would do it. I go to prepare a place for you. If I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, then you may be also. And whether I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know it not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the trump of God. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruption must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruption shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall bring to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be unto God that giveth us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, my beloved, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know, your labor is not in vain in the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and give you peace. You can be seated as the family still possesses him. This is still our waiting period. We have a few minutes, 20, probably, to visit with the family, don't take it in. And then at 11 o'clock, we'll start our worship service. As they're coming, let me give you a few housekeeping rules. The men's bathrooms are on, what is this, my left, your right, etc. The women's are on the opposite side of the room, directly outside of this sanctuary. You are free to move about, go across the street, smoke cigarettes, laugh, and talk. At 11 o'clock, we'll stop worship. Amen.
Yeah. Bread,
Talk about this for a minute. Let not go these drugs. What should we know about death? Death seems to trouble us, it agitates us, it eradicates our thinking, it pushes our schedule, it upsets our plan, it makes us to do stuff that we really don't want to do. When death invades our life, we always have these questions. We want to know who was it that died, when did they die, what caused it, their rise, how did they die. And then we get personal, we want to know how old they were, what was the cause, what did they leave, do I get any of what they did? Your eyes will not open. He will save you in an hour like this. But I say to you that there are 1, 2, 3, 4 churches represented here. Don't wait on this day. Tomorrow, find yourself in a place where you can secure a home for the eternal soul.
More aware that one day we're going to be here too, and that we're going to have to stand at some point before you in judgment. And Lord, we want to hear you say, well done, good and faithful servant. So as we celebrate this life and as we acknowledge that all life belongs to you, we pray that you would encourage us and help us and enable us to live the life that you would have us to live. bless those who are from out of town, oh God. We pray that you give them traveling mercies. Be with them. Those that are here, Lord, let us remember Brother Lynn and rejoice in our memories. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Inasmuch as it's pleased Almighty God and His wise providence to take out of life the soul of our dear brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, looking forward to the general resurrection, the life of the world to come. The earth and the sea shall give up its dead, and the corruptible bodies of them that slept in him shall be changed, made like unto his own glorious body, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a verse from heaven saying, right, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. Henceforth they rest from their labors, and their works do follow. Would you pray the Lord's Prayer with me? Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
On earth,
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day
our daily bread.
Forgive us our debts,
as we forgive our debtors.
Lead us not
into temptation,
but deliver us
from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
and the power,
and the glory,
forever.
Amen. Let's receive the benediction and drive safely back to the church. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and present you from falling and keep you. It is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Go get y'all some chicken.
Yes,